Hi, I'm Stefanie Perrin, Board Certified Behavior Analyst at Brett DiNovi Associates, and I'd like to talk about token economies and some of the important considerations when designing and implementing a token system. Here are some of the task list topics that will be covered in this discussion. Token economy systems are a very common intervention used in the applied setting. However, a lot of the times they are not designed and based on empirical literature. Timothy Hackenberg in 2018 recently synthesized the applied and basic literature and devised evidence-based recommendations for practice. Those recommendations fall into three areas: how to establish tokens as conditioned reinforcers, fading access to the backup reinforcer, and considerations when regarding token loss as a form of negative punishment. Tokens function as conditioned reinforcers due to their pairing with an already established reinforcer. Prior to implementing the token economy, time should be taken to establish the tokens as a reinforcer, as opposed to just presenting the token and the established reinforcer together. It's best practice to use a contingency-based pairing where a response produces a token which is immediately exchanged for the backup reinforcer. This teaches the exchange response and establishes the token as a discriminative stimulus for the exchange. During acquisition, tokens should be produced on a rich schedule such as a fixed ratio 1 or an FR1. Additional token requirements can be added to the system by systematically adding tokens using backwards chaining. As you can see, additional tokens are now being added to the token system. Fading access to the backup reinforcers can occur in two ways. One is to increase the token production requirements, and the other one is to increase the exchange production requirements. And both of these alternates have some limitations. Increasing token production requirements can result in effects such as ratio strain. So previously, an individual would complete one task and earn a token. And when you increase the token production requirement, they now have to complete 4 or 5 demands to access the token, which can weaken responding to produce the token. Whereas increasing the exchange production schedule results in a longer delay to the backup reinforcer. So instead of having to earn 3 tokens, you now have to earn 5 tokens, which in turn weakens the responding to produce tokens early in the system because the earlier tokens signal a long delay to the backup reinforcers. So we need to look to the literature to help determine which of these alternates is best. Tarbox and colleagues in 2006 suggested that increasing the exchange production schedule is best. One reason for this is that as we increase the number of tokens required to produce the backup reinforcer, we tend to increase the magnitude of that reinforcer. One of the things that you can do to mitigate the effects of early tokens signaling those long delays to the reinforcement is to transition to a variable token exchange schedule. In doing this, those early tokens do not consistently signal those long delays to reinforcement. So some important considerations. As the number of tokens produced increases, you want to make sure that you limit the individual from saving tokens, because saved tokens will weaken token production behavior. In addition, you need to ensure to the greatest extent possible that those backup reinforcers are not readily or freely available outside of that token system, because if they are available all the time, this too will weaken that token production behavior. And the last area that we're going to talk about is aversive control. So it may be necessary to combine punishment with token systems. And a common negative punishment is to use token loss contingent on problem behavior. One advantage of token loss is that the negative side effects that are associated with punishment, such as escape and social disruption, that we see with other forms of punishment, have been reported infrequently when token loss is used as a punisher in a token economy system. However, token loss can weaken responding to produce tokens, especially if tokens are produced on a ratio-based schedule. And one way to address this is to transition to a time-based production schedule, such as a variable interval schedule, as these schedules have been shown to be less sensitive to the punishment effects than our ratio-based schedules. And finally, for token loss to be most effective, loss of tokens should be contingent on problem behavior, immediate, and those loss of tokens should be large. For example, the individual needs to lose all of those tokens. I hope you enjoyed the discussion on token economy. Make sure you subscribe to our channel and like this video, and I look forward to reading your comments. Thanks.